was a fairly dark skin, medium to dark skinned black man. When you see him now, he looks like a Hispanic guy, maybe even a white guy.
Yeah.
Is it remarkable to see that kind of difference?
No, I don't think it's remarkable. And in fact, he actually does look much more youthful than he did. And if you look at his photographs before, there's an irregular patchy pigmentation. He's got more skin darkening on the more sun-exposed skin of his forehead, of his upper lip, and that's been successfully lightened. And I would say he's got a very, very good result. In addition, he's had other procedures, I suspect, performed. For example, he's had botulinum toxin, Botox, into the forehead because his brow shape is much more relaxed and elevated than before. He's got much fewer deep forehead lines. He's not pulling his mouth down as much, so I suspect he's had some Botox in this area, so he's lifting his lips a little. And I would, as regards the pigmentation, his skin color on his face is very nice and uniform, and I would suspect he would have used a combination of peels, hopefully with a dermatologist, or laser, such as the Fraxel laser, or one of the other skin lightening lasers, plus a skin lightening cream, hopefully a prescription one. I understand it wasn't. Well, certainly, hopefully a safe one.
Yeah, I mean, he calls it a European cream. Does that tell you anything? I mean, what do you think was in it to give him that kind of dramatic result?
There must have been a hydroquinone in it of some description. You can, as I said before, get lightening with a combination of botanical products. And if he was religious about using that, and if he was religious about applying a daily sun protection in the morning, plus the other treatments, he could have achieved this. Over the last few years, I've seen a definite trend towards Asians and Africans asking for further skin lightening.
And do they say why?
I think it's largely media-driven. I think there's a perception that a lot of their idols do have light-looking skin. Amongst the Asian community, certainly, the whiter brides, the whiter looking males are more attractive in many people's eyes. So I think it's this pattern that's largely media driven. It is a definite factor in a lot of people, which is very sad because several things. One is they may be putting themselves at harm by using skin lightening agents that are too strong and potentially toxic. And secondly, they're never going to, unless they use a permanent lightener, which is very unwise, they're never going to permanently lighten their skin because their genetics will govern how their skin pigments in response to sunlight.
And why would a permanent lightener be very unwise, as you say?
The one that has been used is called Benequin. And it's still very rarely appropriate, and it has to be used medically under dermatologic supervision. And where we'd use it would be if you've got somebody with the skin disease vitiligo, where you lose a lot of pigment and you've got patchy pigmentation, we'd use Benequin in a few patients to try and get a uniform lightening. The reason it's unwise is that it can actually also cause internal reduction of pigment, like pigment at the back of your eyes. And there have been concerns about Benequin. Also, if you totally remove pigment in even black Afro-American skin, you're going to have a higher risk of then skin cancer.
And it's believed that that's what Michael Jackson used, or do we know this?
As regards Michael Jackson did have vitiligo. What skin lightener he actually used is open for question, but my suspicion is at some stage he used Benequin because of the uniformity of the lightening and the slightly sort of grayish lightening that at least appears on on some of his photographs.
Are there natural herbs out there that can lighten skin?
There's quite a number of natural non-prescription ingredients that we use to lighten skin. In fact, I use it in some of my own products. Things like licorice extract, very good skin lightener, mulberry tree extract, niacinamide, some of the antioxidants, some of the vitamin A ingredients. So there's quite a number, and what we tend to do, those of us who are producing these products, we put several of them in the same product. So we're using low levels of very safe, botanically derived ingredients.
And those actually work?
They will work. They won't work nearly as quickly, nor to the same degree as the prescription products, but they're a very good, gentle skin lightener, and in general, they're safe. Where the problem is, I think, arises, is where you've got some of these depigmenting creams sold over the internet, where you've got, they say that they don't give the ingredients. In fact, if you look at some of them, there's another one on there I was looking at this morning that doesn't give the ingredients at all. And so I am suspicious that some of those do contain some of the hydroquinone-like agents that may be unwise.
If you had to say, if women are men are going to do this, what is the most effective way to lighten skin, and what is the safest way?
The safest way is to go and consult a dermatologist, and they can prescribe the appropriate skin creams if they feel it is going to be justified and if they think that it is going to work. You often need combinations of treatments to get the lightening. If you've got a condition where it's warranted, you need often to combine sunscreens in the morning, lightening creams in the evening, sometimes combined with a retin-A-like cream, and then a variety of different lasers depending on the type of skin discoloration, the skin darkening. If it's localized, we'll use a ruby laser. If it's more generalized, we'll use something like the Fraxel laser or the intense pulse light. So it really depends on the clinical picture that's before me to help me decide what I'm going to use. But yes, there are a variety of different ways that in the appropriate person we can safely reduce discoloration.